إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, I chose to remind you today the day of the Jumu'ah and the obligation. This is a topic that is important and needs to be repeated often so that the message, inshallah, will settle and will reach, and so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may open up our hearts and minds so that we give this day and this salah its due right, especially right now the time has changed, the daylight saving time has started, and the salawat have come closer to one another, and the timing of salah is shorter, so we need to pay more attention to keeping our duty towards our salah, the five daily prayers in general, and the salat al-jum'ah in specific. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Your Lord creates whatever He wishes, and He chooses and selects. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses and selects. He is the one who does that. مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the choice is not theirs. The choice is not theirs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose this very day, the day of Jumu'ah, from the whole week, from the days of the week. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose and selected this day, giving it special excellences. So this day is the best day on which the sun has risen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as in the hadith from Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, narrated by Imam Muslim, that خير يوم طلعت عليه الشمس يوم الجمعة. The best day on which the sun has risen is the day of الجمعة. فيه خلق آدم. In it Adam was created. وفيه أدخل الجنة. In it he was entered into paradise. وفيه أخرج منها. In it he was expelled from it. ولا تقوم الساعة إلا في يوم الجمعة. The hour is not going to be established except on the day of Al-Jumu'ah. The day of Al-Jumu'ah is a day for washing away, cleansing us from the sins that we have committed. That is the minor sins that we have committed during the week. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من اغتسل يوم الجمعة وتطهر بما استطاع من طهر. The one who takes a bath on the day of Jumu'ah, purified himself in whatever way he could purify himself, ثم الدهن أو مس من طيب. Then he oiled himself or he perfumed himself. ثم راح فلم يفرق بين اثنين. Then he went, he did not separate between two people. Meaning walk in between two people. Meaning came early and did not need to do that to get a spot. As some people who come late, they will try to go further and further, and they will separate between the people. The one who does not separate between two people, فصلى ما كتب له. He prays whatever Allah destined for him. ثم إذا خرج الإمام أنصت. Then when the Imam shows up, he listens. غفر له ما بينه وبين الجمعة الأخرى. رواه الإمام البخاري. It is forgiven. His sins are forgiven between this Jumu'ah and the other one. In another authentic narration, وَزِيَادَةُ ثَلَاثَةِ أَيَّامٍ. An extra 3 days. A day which gives you the forgiveness washes the sins, the minor sins that is, because the major sins, they need repentance. The minor sins are washed away. Minor sins committed within 10 days. They are washed and cleansed by this day of Al-Jumu'ah. As in another hadith also narrated by Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, that Rasulullah s.a.w. said, As-salawatu al-khams, the five daily prayers, wal-jumu'atu ila al-jumu'ah, jumu'ah to the next jumu'ah, yani praying a jumu'ah, then praying another jumu'ah after it, wa ramadan ila ramadan, ramadan to the next ramadan, yani fasting ramadan, then fasting another one, mukaffiratun ma baynahun, they wash away, they serve to expiate for the sins that are between, that are in between. Yani fajr, you pray it, then you pray dhuhr. Allah forgives what is between the two prayers. Dhuhr till asr. You pray asr, Allah forgives what is between dhuhr and asr. Then what is between asr and maghrib. Then what is between maghrib and isha. This is, every day we have this opportunity. These are the five daily prayers. They serve to wash away the minor sins committed in between. Then we have another weekly opportunity, and this is the day of Al-Jumu'ah. Friday to the other Friday, the sins in between are washed. Then you have a yearly type of washing and cleansing of the sins from one Ramadan to the next Ramadan. The sins that are in between are washed and cleansed. A lot of opportunities for us to be cleared of the sins that we commit. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مُكَفِّرَاتٌ مَا بَيْنَهُنْ إِذَا اجْتُنِبَتِ الْكَبَائِرِ, they will serve to wash away what is in between as long as the major sins are avoided. This is narrated by Al-Imam Muslim. Also, from the excellences of the day of Jumu'ah is that it has a time span in it, a period of time, and it is a short period of time in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the dua. This is an opportunity that is open for us every Friday. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that it is an hour in which no Muslim would be asking anything except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him that. لا يسأل فيها مسلم شيئا إلا أعطاه. Allah Azza wa Jal will give him that, whatever he is asking. And this time period, Allah knows best, is the last period of the day. The last period of the day, as in an authentic hadith in the Sunan of Abu Dawood and An-Nasa'i, فَالْتَمِسُوهَا آخِرَ سَاعَةٍ بَعْدَ الْعَصْرِ, seek it the last period of time after Asr. So it is after Asr, and it is closer toward Maghrib time. Closer towards Maghrib time. There is another narration which mentions that it is between the time when the Imam sits and the time when he leaves from the Salah. Now that hadith is not a strong hadith. However, some scholars, they say that this time also, the time of Jumu'ah, is also a time generally that in which the dua is answered. That is because it is a time when the Muslims gather together, and in a time like this, if they make dua and they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is very much hoped that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer whatever they ask Him for. However, Allah knows best in terms of that specific time period on the day of Al-Jumu'ah, then it is, as was mentioned, after Asr and towards the very end of the day, closer to the time of Al-Maghrib, inshallah ta'ala. It is legislated for us to recite the Quran in general and to recite the Surah Al-Kahf on the day of Al-Jumu'ah. It is also legislated for us to say a lot of salah and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as the sending of salah and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is something that will be shown to him alayhi as-salatu was-salam, as in the authentic hadith that the salah is shown and presented to him alayhi as-salatu was-salam. So this is something that we always need to do, and salah and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has a lot of reward in it. Enough for a reward for it is that if you say one salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, he sends salah upon you, meaning he raises and elevates your status. He mentions you with good subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you say one salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself will raise, will elevate your status and will mention you 10 times. If this is the only reward for salah ala al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then that would be sufficient. So what about that the case is that it has so many other excellences that are mentioned in the sunnah that should encourage us to do a lot of salah and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the things that are legislated for us to do on the day of Jumu'ah, and that is something that we should do after the timing of Fajr enters, after the time of dawn, and that is to take a bath for the day of Jumu'ah. As in the hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man tawadda'a yawm al-jum'ah fabiha wa ni'mat, wa man ightasala fahuwa afdal." The one who makes wudu on the day of al-jum'ah, then that is good and that is something great that he has done. And the one who took a bath, then that is better. That is better. This is narrated by Imam Ahmad and other than him. And there are other narrations that the taking a bath or bathing on the day of Jumu'ah is haqq and or wajib, that it is a right, that it is a must. And a number of scholars took from that the ghusl on the day of Jumu'ah is not only something that is highly emphasized, rather it is something that is obligatory. So this is something that we should not be missing on the day of Al-Jum'ah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم. وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. In shaa Allah, I would like to ask the brothers to move a little bit forward so there is room for the brothers who are standing in the back. One of the things that I must remind you of is that it is obligatory to listen to the khutbah. وجوب الاستماع للخطبة. وتحريم الكلام والخطيب يخطب. The prohibition of speaking while the imam is giving the speech. هذه من الأشياء التي تتكرر خصوصا من كبار السن، مع أنهم يناصحون وينصحون المرة تلو الأخرى والمرة تلو الأخرى والمرة تلو الأخرى، لكن إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون، والهداية بيد الله عز وجل وحده. لا يجوز الكلام والإمام يخطب على المنبر، حتى للأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر لا يجوز، يجب الاستماع للخطبة. فكيف بالدخول والسلام عليكم وكيف حالكم والمصافحة والكلام؟ نبهنا عليها مرارا وتكرارا ومرارا وتكرارا وما زالت تتكرر وتكرر، ويدخلون ويدخل الداخل ويكلم شخصا يعني لا يريد أن يتكلم معه ولا يريد أن يرد عليه، لكن يعني يحرجونهم. فإذا أحرجت فلا تستجيب للإحراج، لا تستجيب له، إذا كلمك كأنه غير موجود. Those who walk in and they corner some people, they come to you and they stretch out their hands, they say السلام عليكم, they corner you, you feel shy not to respond to them. They ruin their Jumu'ah and they ruin your Jumu'ah. It is okay. If this is rudeness, be rude in this case. Just don't mind them, as if he's not there, as if he did not talk to you. until they learn and they follow the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because this is something that is repeated again and again, especially from our elders, and they repeat, and the youngs too, and the young. They repeat doing it again and again as if nothing is mentioned. And this is something that has been mentioned not once or 10 times or 20 or 50, even more than that. But still, over the years, no change. Except whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided their hearts. The talking during the Jumu'ah, it will make you lose the reward of your Jumu'ah. That is basically what it is. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith that إِذَا قُلْتَ لِصَاحِبِكَ أَنصِتْ يَوْمَ الْجُمْعَةِ وَالْإِمَامِ يَخْطُبْ فَقَدْ لَغَوْتْ. If you tell your brother, your companion, you tell him on the day of Jumu'ah, listen, if you find them talking, and this is something wrong, you're not supposed to talk to him to tell him, listen and pay attention, keep quiet and listen. Is even that is not allowed. So what about talking about this and that and how are you and shaking hands and salamu alaikum? There is no, it's not allowed, period. We have to follow the sunnah. Otherwise, you are losing your reward. The reward of the Jumu'ah becomes the reward of Dhuhr, as in another narration that is authentic. So we need to abide by this and not to get involved in anything else but listening and paying attention to the Jumu'ah. If you tell the one who is next to you on the day of Jumu'ah while the Imam is giving the speech, listen, فَقَدْ لَغَوْتْ, then you have involved yourself in unnecessary vain talk. وَمَنْ لَغَى فَلَا جُمْعَةَ لَهُ. And the one who gets involved in vain talk, then he would have no Jumu'ah. He would have no Jumu'ah. If something happens, you can talk to the Imam, and the Imam can talk to you. If the Imam spoke to you, you answer back. If there is something wrong that happened, you come in and you direct your speech to the Imam. You tell the Imam, and then the Imam will reply to you. If there is a need, and this is something that does happen, but rarely it would happen. Rarely it would happen. So you do not get involved also in anything else other than paying attention after the Imam shows up. No siwak, no touching of the floor or picking things that are on the floor, trying to be nice or cleaning the masjid or taking lint or some pieces that are on the floor. Do not touch anything and do not get involved even in dhikr. Someone might be sitting and saying, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. This is not allowed during the khutbah. Not allowed. You have to only listen to what the Imam is saying. Nawafil also are not allowed except for Tahiyyatul Masjid. When you enter, do not sit until you pray two rak'at, then you sit after that. Because we have a direct, explicit hadith in this regard. Even some scholars took from that this two rak'at, many scholars, they are of the view that it is a must. Although the majority, they say that Tahiyyatul Masjid is a highly emphasized and recommended salah. But then from this, they said because listening to the khutbah is a must. And if you come in, you are not supposed to sit until you pray two rak'at, nawafil, then it means that this nafila is very strongly emphasized. It should not be looked down upon. However, even this salah that is legislated, the two rak'at, you do not take a long time in that. You pray it short, as Rasulullah ﷺ commanded that man who entered. He asked him, did you pray? He said, no. He said, stand up, pray two rak'at, wa'awjiz, and he prayed them short. Do not recite long surahs. Short but complete. Short but complete. Not the quick one where you do not perform ruku' properly and you do not stand up properly. Rather, complete, but then you make them short. You don't take a long time praying these two rak'at. The Salatul Jumu'ah does not have a sunnah ratiba, that is regular sunnah attached to it before the salah. It does not have that. Whenever you enter, you pray two rak'at, four rak'at, six rak'at, eight rak'at, up until the Imam shows up. If the Imam shows up and he is giving the khutbah, then if you enter then after he starts, then you pray only the two rak'at and then you sit and listen to the remembrance after the Jumu'ah, the Sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is to either pray two rak'at after the Jumu'ah or four rak'at after the Jumu'ah. It is highly recommended to come early to the Jumu'ah. Do your best to come here. The ahadith about this has been mentioned so many times, I do not want to repeat them again. We are advertising that the Jumu'ah starts at 1. I actually give few minutes after that, sometimes 5 minutes, sometimes 10 minutes, so that people will reach and will reach on time. Unfortunately, because there is this 5 to 10 minute window, then we have people coming 1:15 and 1:20. If they are excused, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who will hold them responsible. We know that there are people who have excuses. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, they are not meant by any type of blame. But those who are able to come early, yet they are looking down, they are treating this opportunity that Allah has given them, they are treating it as if it's not there. A day of Jumu'ah is just like another day, just another Friday. We come like this ibadah became like a habit, a custom. Just you come in there, you walk in, you walk out, and like a checkbox, Salatul Jumu'ah is done. It should not be like that. We need to be more cautious about this day of the week because it's a special day. A special day of the week. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it that excellence, so we should hold high, in high esteem, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made excel over other things. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who listen to a statement and follow the best of it, to open our hearts, to our minds, to his guidance subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inna nas'aluka min al-khayri kullih ajilihi wa ajilih ma 'alimna minhu wa ma lam na'lam wa na'udhu bika min ash-sharri kullih ajilihi wa ajilih ma 'alimna minhu wa ma lam na'lam. نسألك اللهم من خير ما سألك عبدك نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ بك منه عبدك نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واهدنا سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور وجنبنا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن وبارك لنا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وقلوبنا وأزواجنا وذرياتنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واجعلنا شاكرين لنعمك مثنين بها عليك قابلين لها وأتممها علينا. اللهم نجي المستضعفين من المؤمنين. اللهم أدخلهم مدخل صدق وأخرجهم مخرج صدق واجعل لهم من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا. اللهم انصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم أحصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم أحدا. اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم. اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم. اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم. اللهم أصلحنا وأصلح أزواجنا وذرياتنا وأصلح بلاد المسلمين وولاة أمورهم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. جزاكم الله خيرا.